Okay, just a couple more things before we get the night going here. One thing is, I talked a little bit at the PALS about live music, and live music is an extremely important part of your education as a guitarist or as a musician. Performing live is super important. If you can get a chance to get out and play, that's really important. Go to an open mic night, set up a gig and go out and play. That's great. When you go to open mic night, make sure you support the venue that's running that open mic night by purchasing something and contributing to that business as well, because they want to create a live format for you, but they have to make it worth, it has to be worth their while, so the musicians that show up should especially support those venues. The other thing is, live music will not be what it was to all of us if we don't all go out and support live music. If the artists are not in the audience, if artists don't show up to see live music, it's going to be much harder for us to convince other people they should come out for live music. So as an artist and as a musician, it's imperative that you go out and support other artists, whether they're local artists or national artists, on a regular basis, so that those venues that run those shows can exist, and so those performers have a venue to be able to share their art with you. It's on us as our generations to make sure that the future generations have a place to go out and perform their art and an audience that's there. So we need to be that audience. So next time you're sitting around wondering what to do, go out and see some live music. Go see a play. Do something to see a performing artist, whether it's somebody in a coffee shop or on the Landmark stage. It matters that you are there. It really does. The way the Guitar League works, we're going to do the normal break announcement right now, is that we break up after the main performance into three sections. One is the beginner section of the rookies, the intermediate, which is the minors, and then the majors, which usually hangs around up front here with whoever's presenting. Nobody is required to go to any particular skill level. You can be brand new and show up with the majors or the minors, it doesn't matter. You could have been playing the guitar for 70 years and be a pro and hang out with the rookies. And you can get up in the middle of whatever's going on and switch rooms and do whatever you want. You can go in the corner and jam, you can leave. There is no real strict format here. But what we offer is a rookie, a major, and a minor, and a major setting, so that there are different challenges to the level. Nobody has to be at any particular meeting to get something out of each lesson. So each lesson is a self-encapsulated lesson. So it wasn't something last month you had to get in order to be able to be a part of this month. The rookies this time around will be led by John Wolford, and John is going to teach three basic songs. So he's going to bring your guitars over, get them out, and you can learn something from him. The second person that will be teaching is Bruce Wood. Bruce is a great fingerstyle player and a very good teacher. He's going to be teaching three-note voicings on the guitar, so how to use three notes to make a really cool melody. Then the last, whoever wants, can hang around with the Martin presenter here and ask questions, show guitars, learn, whatever you would like to do. Because the way the room is set up, we normally divide this room, so that this is a separate room and we have the meeting on that side. When the meeting's breaks, we're going to want to move these chairs, and we're going to have to move these dividers forward. So if everybody in this section can help us out, get your chairs out of the way, we can divide this up, and that way we'll probably have the Martin side stay here, and the rookies will go to that side, or the minors, whoever's got more. And then we have the third room over here. So I'd like to bring to the stage a gentleman who's been a longtime supporter of the Guitar League, and is obviously very interested in the Martin guitar, and has spent some time down at their factory, and he's a wonderful person. His name is Doc Edkin.
I own a couple of Martins. Dick knew that before he got hit by the bus, I think, that's laid him up. He asked me if I would kind of help with the introduction tonight, and I'm really happy to do that. We've got Joel Zagone with us tonight. He started in 06 with the Martin Company, just working in the factory. By 09, he was an assistant manager. He's now a manager in one of the departments at Martin, and he's also gotten involved in this outreach program, going to folk and bluegrass festivals. He's begun to play. He plays out. He says that he's all Martin all the time. And with that introduction, I'd like to give you Joel Zagone.